චන්ඩි පැන්ඩා සමට සූදු බවට ඇමරිකාවෙන් සහතික ලත් එකම විෂබීජනාශක සබන්.
The 9th of November this year, President Maithripala Sirisena issued a gazette notification dissolving parliament almost 20 months before its term ends. However, 13 fundamental rights petitions were soon filed by political parties, including the United National Party, the Janata Vimukti Peramuna, the Tamil National Alliance, Tamil Progressive Alliance, and the All Ceylon People's Congress, as well as organizations and activists, the Center for Policy Alternatives, Attorney Aruna Laksiri, and also a member of Elections Commission, Professor S.R. Rich Hule, challenging the decision by the President to dissolve Parliament. These petitioners sought an order nullifying the President's move. Considering the petitions, the Supreme Court issued an interim order on the 13th of November, temporarily suspending the gazette by the President until a ruling is delivered on the petitions. In the meantime, on the 3rd of December, the Court of Appeal issued an interim order restraining Mahinda Rajapaksa from continuing as Prime Minister and his cabinet from functioning. A 7-member judge bench comprising Chief Justice Nalin Pereira, Supreme Court Justices Priyanta Jayawardena, Prasanna Jayawardena, Sisira Diabru, Vijit Malalgoda, Bhuvanekar Alubihare and Murdu Fernando commenced hearing petitions on the 4th of this month. On Friday last week, the 7th of December, the Supreme Court concluded hearing submissions on the petitions and intervenient submissions against the petitions after 4 consecutive days of hearings. The Supreme Court, while reserving judgment, did not fix a date on which the verdict will be delivered. Supreme Court also extended the interim order issued earlier, suspending the gazette notification on the dissolution of Parliament until its ruling is pronounced. In this backdrop, it was announced this morning that the much-anticipated ruling by Supreme Court would be delivered at 4 this evening. Security around the Supreme Court was beefed up by then. A large number of parliamentarians and political party supporters were seen at the court premises as well. The 7-member judge bench, however, arrived at the Supreme Court at around 5 this evening. Delivering the verdict, Chief Justice Nalin Pereira said that the gazette notification issued by the President dissolving Parliament is inconsistent with the country's constitution. It was also pronounced that it is the opinion of the Supreme Court judge bench that fundamental rights of the petitioners had been breached by way of the gazette dissolving Parliament. Chief Justice Nalin Pereira thereby announced that the said gazette is null and void before the law. Meanwhile, member of the bench Justice Sisira Diabru, who stood to explain the reason for his decision to agree with such a ruling. He noted that as per Article 70, Sub-Article 1 of the Constitution, the President does not have the mandate to dissolve Parliament, according to his will, before 4.5 years. He further said that in order for the President to do so, a 2/3 of Parliament must make a request from the President. Accordingly, the 7-member judge bench unanimously declared that the gazette notification issued by the President to dissolve Parliament is inconsistent with the Constitution.